Well, I've been having some rough running issues with this vehicle recently, and the symptoms are pretty much misfire-like, but it is actually worse when it is cold. So what I'm thinking about doing is a leak-off test. And I did hear that you can use some old bottle tops. So I've got a couple of bottle tops here. I've actually got five, one for each cylinder. And I'm going to trim these down to size. Well, I have done some off-camera trial and error, and we've got the holes in there, the actual size. I'm actually using a 10mm drill bit here, and I've came up with the best way, I think, of doing it. This is a drill bit you'd use for wood. It's not steel, but it does have an advantage. It's got a point there and a couple of edges which are good at burring. So I don't even use a drill for this. All I'm doing is I just turn. So that's through the bottle top there. And then, now I've learned not to go clockwise, which is the direction of the drill. You can see there's a little circle forming. I just go counterclockwise against the direction you'd normally drill, and just twist it manually. I see it's starting to come out in a lovely circle. I've stretched the plastic ever so slightly. I suppose you could use the drill in reverse. Anyway, I can trim that off and neaten that up with a pair of snips. So I've found I can just cut pieces of plastic away that are surplus, work my way around it, taking care not to enlarge the hull, and for good measure, a round file. That'll just deburr everything. Not going too mad with that. And then we'll go to the injector, and hopefully it should be a nice tight fit. So we'll try this one I've just made in front of your very eyes over the top of an injector, and it's more or less an exact fit. Slightly tighter would be better, as we're going to be containing a bit of fluid. I'll just give it a little push around the edge, and we've got another four to do. Well, that's all five cylinders done for this engine, and you can see here there's a little slit. So what I've done is I've worked my way around, just pressing with a screwdriver, just to get that, get them as low as possible, just so we don't have any diesel escaping unchecked. And I think they're all good, so we'll start the engine up and see what gives. Yeah, we have found one hell of a problem on the central injector and there. So it didn't really want to start, but now I've got it started, I'm going to kill it. So these two injectors are obviously out of spec. I did hear of running an engine for a minute to check the rate of 25 millilitres is not exceeded, but this one is the worst. You can see you've got diesel fluid down there, and this one is too. So that's two injectors I'm gonna have to potentially replace, and the other three seem, I would say, about right. The test did take in the region of 30 seconds and it was surprisingly fast. These caps, incidentally, before we drilled holes in them, we actually had a capacity of 11 millilitres, and these are taken from 2-litre milk cartons. You can see we've got a couple of different dairies going off there. But I now know we're having at least two injectors in this vehicle, and I'll be honest with you, it hasn't been running right for some time, but it is better when it is warm. So I've spent quite a bit of time cleaning up, and I'm just making a note of the number of this injector so I can buy one absolutely identical, so the coding all matches, So it should just be plug and play when I get round to replacing the two injectors. And then I think I'll repeat the leak off test. So I'm just refitting things. And then I think what I'll do, once I get the full leak off pipe refitted, you can see there's diesel down there, I'll just watch to see if there's any bubbles coming back up, because there could be some badly sealing injectors and compression loss could be part of the problem. Well, it's been a good few days now and I have replaced one of the troublesome injectors and the car is running a lot better now, but we do have a little bit of an issue with this injector here. It's stuck, so I don't want to go too much into it in this video because I have a video all about that and I'm going to run the car and try and remove it. But the good news is replacing this injector here has caused the car to run immensely better and the engine light has disappeared. It idles a lot smoother and it's a more drivable car. We know what, no engine warnings whatsoever. But they're still work in progress because we've got this one to replace. But I'm just gently removing this injector the patient way. And many thanks for watching. And why not subscribe? And if you want to see that video, you will find it here.